Today, I am going to show you guys how to make my vibrant bikini top. And these are the materials you're going to need. You're going to need a hook in the size 3.75 millimeters or size F. You're also going to need some scissors, a yarn needle, and then I used Ice Brand 100% mercerized cotton. And you can use any cotton DK weight. And then you're also going to need about 10 to 12 feet of elastic for the edges. So in this video, I chained 13, but you guys, I suggest you just chain 12. This will be for about a size medium, chain 10 for a small, probably 14 for a large. And once you chain it, you're going to go into the third chain down, and you're going to do a half double crochet, which is a yarn over, insert hook, pull through, yarn over, and then pull through all the loops on the hook. And you're going to do that all the way down into the very end of your chain. And you're going to want to do this kind of tightly, you know, since this is going to be the cup of your top, so you don't want any holes in it. And when you get to the last chain, you are going to do two half double crochets in that chain. Then you're going to chain one, and then you're going to do two more half double crochets in that same chain space. And then now you're kind of working on the reverse side of that chain, and you're going to do one half double crochet in each chain space on the back side all the way down to where you made your first chain. Then once you get to this point, you're going to want to make sure that you have the same amount of half double crochets on each side. Otherwise, you might be a little bit uneven. So I just counted right there to make sure I had the same amount on each side. And the chain two does count as the first half double crochet. And so this side, you're going to chain two again, and then you're not going to half double crochet into that same first stitch. You're going to go into the next one since the chain counts as the first half double crochet. You're going to do one half double crochet in each stitch all the way up the top until you get to that chain one space that you made in the very top of the cup in the previous row. And you're going to do two half double crochets, chain one, and then two more half double crochets in that chain one space from the previous row. And then again, you are going to do one half double crochet in each stitch all the way down to the bottom. And then when you reach the bottom, again, you're going to chain two, turn, not half double crochet in that first one, but half double crochet in the next one, and go all the way back up to the top of the cup again until you get to that chain one space, where you will do the two half double crochets, chain one, two half double crochets, and then you're going to do this and go back and forth in a U shape for about 10 rows. This is the end of my 10th row. This is about what your cup should look like at this point. Now we are going to chain one, and we are going to begin to single crochet along the bottom of the cup. And I did about one single crochet for each row on the bottom there of half double crochets, so around 20. It gets a little funky when you get in the middle, but it really doesn't matter how many there is. You just want to do it as evenly spaced out as possible. I like to do mine a little bit looser so that it doesn't bunch at all. So just do the best you can, and you're going to do this all the way across the bottom of the cup. Once you reach the end, you are basically done with your first cup. You're going to cut and tie off, and you are going to do the same exact thing for your second cup, except for when you get to the end of your second cup, do not tie off. Keep your yarn attached to your piece. So this is the end of my second cup. And so now you have two, and we are going to connect the two cups. So to do this, we're going to chain one, and again, we are going to single crochet along the bottom of the cup all the way across. And you're going to keep doing this until you get to the very end. You're going to chain one, then you're going to insert your hook into the corner of the next cup, and you're going to pull up a loop. Sorry, I connected with a single crochet. You can do a single crochet or a slip stitch for this. And then again, you're going to just single crochet in each stitch all the way across until you get to the other end of your second cup. And once you get to that other end, you are going to begin to make a really long chain that's going to reach around your back, all the way around your body to reach the other side. And this is going to be basically the back strap. You're going to want it to fit super loosely. The elastic will tighten it up because you want to be able to get it on over your head. I chained 86 for this, for reference. Here I tried on for you so you can see how loose it actually is. You can make it a little bit tighter than that, but I like to make it so that I can get it on over my head super easy. And then once you do that, you've connected it with a slip stitch. You're now going to chain four, and then you are going to skip the next chain, and you're going to do a double crochet in the second chain. And that is a yarn over, insert hook, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, and then yarn over and pull through the last two loops on your hook. And then you're going to chain one, skip a chain, double crochet in the next, chain one, skip a chain space, double crochet in the next. So basically you're going to do a double crochet, chain one, and then skip the next space and double crochet again and repeat that all the way around your entire top until you get back to the other side. And you kind of want to make sure your chain isn't twisted. You want to try and keep it as level as possible. And when you get to the other side, before you connect it, please make sure that your chain isn't twisted. You want to make sure that you didn't flip it over in the process of you going around it, because otherwise that's really frustrating and you're going to get halfway through your top and realize that you twisted it. So now we're going to do the second row for our elastic casing, and you're again going to chain four, and then you're basically going to do a double crochet right in top of the next double crochet. You're going to chain one and then go again into the top of the next double crochet, and you're going to do that all the way around the top again, and then slip stitching with the third chain up from your first chain four that you started with. Once you've reached this point, you're going to tie off again, and then we are going to connect right there at that double crochet that I just pointed out to you, and begin to do the casing for the elastic along the side of the cup. And my dog is licking me. You're going to do this all the way up the side. You're going to do the same, chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next, chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. And this first one is a little weird because you have those two rows of double crochets. So I just, or sorry, single crochets. I skipped the first row of single crochets and then did my chain one and continued to do that right along the top. And you're going to want to do this right until you get to the top point of your cup, because at that point we are going to start the strap for that goes over your shoulder and connects to the back. And so I went and did up to one right before the chain one space of the last half double crochet that was on that cup. And this is what it should look like at this point. So you can start getting an idea. You can see it starting to come together. And you're going to start doing your chain. I again chained 86. You could probably get away with doing 75, 76 chains. And, you know, just measure it against yourself. Again, you're going to want this to be really loose because the elastic will tighten it up. But I will say this doesn't need to be as loose as the strap that went around your back. And once you have your chain, you're going to connect it to the back. I did it in the 14th double crochet across from the side of my cup. You can choose wherever you want, whatever's most comfortable for you, you know, try it on and look at it. But whatever you do, however many double crochets from the side of the cup you did, you're going to want to do the same number of double crochets from the other side for your other strap so that they're even. And then connect with a slip stitch. Do a single crochet around the chain one space, and then do another single crochet in the top of the next double crochet. And then you're going to chain one and turn. And then now you're going to be doing the same double crochet, chain one, skip a stitch, double crochet, chain one, skip a stitch, all the way back up the strap. And before you connect it up there, again, make sure that the strap isn't twisted at all, because otherwise, my first top I made of this pattern when I was testing it out, I did twist the strap and I didn't realize it, and I finished the entire top and realized when I went to put my elastic in that the strap was twisted. So you would have to undo rows and rows of crochet or leave it twisted, so please, please, please make sure that you are double checking that, because I didn't. And once you get here, I skipped over that chain one space, and I just did another double crochet right on the left side of it. And you're going to do the same chain one, double crochet, chain one, skip one, all the way down until you get to the middle where the cups connect. And then once you reach this point, you can stop one double crochet, chain one from the top, and just chain one and double crochet to the other side. And this leaves a little bit bigger of a gap on the bottom, which means your elastic won't come all the way down to the elastic that's on the bottom of it. And that, I mean, it depends on, I guess, what kind of look you're going for. I opted to just do one more chain one double crochet right down to the bottom of the cup, which I'll show you right here, because I just knew that I wanted my elastic to meet in the middle all the way down to the bottom elastic. And then I chained one again, and then I went across and did a double crochet right on the bottom of the second cup, chained one, and then began going up. And so you're going to do those two bottom crochets, those bottom double crochets, literally right onto the bottom connecting chain from when you first connected your cups. And then you're going to do the same pattern of the double crochet, chain one, skip a stitch, all the way up to the top of your cup, And then you're going to do chain the same amount of chains as you did for the last cup for the strap. You're going to chain down, connect it. Again, make sure the strap isn't twisted when you get back to the top. And then you're going to do the same thing along the outer side of the cup, connect it, and then tie off. And at this point, we are pretty much done, I think, with all the crocheting for this top. And we're just going to weave in all of our ends, and we're going to start cutting our elastic. And so you're going to need a piece of elastic that is going to go from the outer edge of the cup all the way up through the shoulder strap and then all the way back down and connects to the bottom. I like to cut mine a little bit bigger than I think so that I can tie them, and it just gives you a little bit room for error. So you're going to need two of those that are the same size. And then you're going to need one piece for the middle that's going to go down the inner side of the cup, connect at the bottom, and then go back up the top. And again, cut that a little bit loose. And then you're going to need two pieces of elastic that go around like your ribcage area. And like I said, all of these, you're going to want to cut them fairly loosely because then you're going to adjust and tighten them later. I folded it in half and then attached the safety pin because this is fold over elastic that I'm using. And it's 5/8 inch. So you guys are wondering, I'll put a link down in the bottom so you guys can see what kind of elastic it is. And you're going to basically weave it in and out of these casings that you made for them. And once you weave it in and out, I think I'm just going to meet you right back in the beginning. And then you're going to tie it in a knot when you reach the point where you started. And that's just to secure it temporarily so you can try it on and adjust it later. You do the same thing with your second piece of elastic. You know, you can use all one color. You can use two colors like I did. You can use a different color for every strap, you know. Just do whatever fits you, I guess. And these are the colors I chose. It's the colors I made for my bottoms when I made this bikini. So now you're going to tie onto the bottom corner and you're going to weave your elastic all the way up the side of your cup, through the strap, all the way back and tie it in the back. And that's what it'll look like when that piece is done. And then you're gonna do the same thing on the other side. And then lastly, we are going to attach the elastic in the middle. I used pink again for this. Just tie it on in the corner. Attach it to your safety pin. Weave it through. You want to make sure the elastic isn't getting all twisted when you weave these in because it's just a pain. It's easier to keep it straight as you go than trying to straighten it all out at the end. When I got to the middle here, I think I went under, then folded it over and came back on the top. And later, after I tried it on, I ended up adjusting the way I weaved the elastic through the middle. So you're just going to play with it a little bit and see what works best for you. But once you get it through there, you're again going to tie it. And then you got to kind of shuffle the elastic back through to get it to evenly spread across your top. At this point, you are going to want to try it on, which I did, and then I pinned where I wanted the elastic to be so it fit me best. And then you're going to want to sew the elastic where you did all of your knots. And for the back of the top, I opened the elastic and layered one end over the other and stitched all around the edges of that. And then I folded it back in half and just did a straight stitch through that to help the fold lay flat. And then for all of the straps, I had the fold over elastic go around the bottom strip of elastic, I guess, that went around the band. And then I folded it back over itself and sewed it to itself on the wrong side of it. I'm not an expert at sewing. You don't have to be. You can hand stitch it. You can machine stitch it. It doesn't matter. This is what my top ended up looking like, so you guys can get an idea if yours is similar or not. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions or suggestions,
please leave them in the comments below. I will try and get answer everyone's questions. I do have a pattern for the bottoms that match this top, but it is just a written pattern on my blog, and I will link that below as well. Thank you for watching, and please, 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 if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me, and I will do my best to help you. And, you know, subscribe if you want more crochet tutorials. Thank you.